Hi, and welcome to Enchantment of Eternity's review for Dark Matter Season 2, Episode 6, We Should Have Seen This Coming. This video is a part of a series of videos where I review episodes of Dark Matter, so I have to give a spoiler warning for Dark Matter up to Season 2, Episode 6. If you haven't seen up to this point, you may not want to watch this video, otherwise some things may be spoiled for you. So, I have mixed feelings about this episode, as on the one hand, I love getting Nix's backstory, and I do think it was indeed compelling, and they introduced a fascinating new villain, perhaps the best that we've had on this show so far, but on the other hand, the episode was kind of boring, and I was sorely disappointed in the ending, which was all too predictable. So first thing I've got to talk about is the android is back to normal in this episode. It kind of annoys me that she's instantly her old self again, but at least they did address it and didn't try to brush it off. However, I find her reasonings for deactivating the upgrades a bit flimsy, to say the least. I think they could have done a better job at coming up with reasons on why she would stop using the upgrade other than her simply wanting to be her old self. That was a piece of lazy writing, if you ask me. However, I did find it interesting that she still has the upgrade and could use it again whenever it's required. And personally, I hope they eventually explore this dynamic more and how she feels about using this upgrade as opposed to not using it. But for now, it's a convenient plot device to have this character go back to normal. So this is the episode in which we inevitably get Nix's backstory, and I have to say I was really impressed with it, as it was much better than I thought it would be, as they've been hinting at it for a while that there was something really special about her, but honestly I thought it would be another 2 type revelation, where it was like an artificial enhancement or something like that, but apparently not. Apparently she has the ability to predict the most likely outcome of the immediate future, which is why she's such a good fighter, because she can see which moves her opponent is going to make before they know it themselves. They weren't entirely clear on the extent of her powers, but it seems like they're not quite as strong as that of her brother or of the Seers. So apparently they tracked down the corporate lady whom Rex was communicating with and plan on going after her for answers. However, to do this is such a huge ask, and they need to stock up on supplies, so they plan a raid. And Nix has the right target in mind, which of course ends up being her old people, whom she had escaped from, as she uses the raid to rescue her brother, who apparently has the strongest future-telling abilities out of anyone. And so the Seers, as they're called, that use her people to predict the future, go on a chase to get him back, which leads to them predicting the Ross's every move. So I love these Seers. I thought the whole concept was a very interesting one, and it makes them a very powerful adversary, probably the most interesting and difficult to defeat that they've come across yet. Also, this episode makes Nix an extremely interesting character, who not only has psychic powers, but this episode also made her feel more human, and plus she's feeling more like a normal member of the crew as she's really starting to bond with the crew, particularly with Four. However, where this episode falters for me is the way the conflict was resolved. So they set up this huge conundrum where 3 and 6 are trapped on a planet where they can't survive on for long, but the Raza can't go back for them because the Seers would predict that. And it leads 2 in the crew to second guess themselves, as they don't know what to do, as the Seers will probably see it coming. So this was an interesting setup. This is an interesting problem. So they set themselves up for some great storytelling potential, but instead this episode just fell flat on its face, as what happened next was, after doing nothing for a while, we got a few pointless boring scenes with Nix and her brother, they just go back to the planet with no real plan. That is, because, you know, this is the potential for 2. She could have, having to second guess herself, she was forced to actually do something unpredictable, but instead she didn't. She just did like the normal thing you would expect them to do, and of course the Seers show up again and corner them. duh. And so Two tries the very stupid plan to bluff that she'll kill Nix's brother. And of course they see right through it and tell that she's bluffing, which is the biggest no-duh ever. I mean, why in the hell would she ever think this would work in the first place? So they ended up just having to surrender him to the Seers anyway. My god, that is such an uninteresting conclusion. One of the worst that this show has ever done. They had the opportunity for Two to come up with some really brilliant and clever plan that the audience and the Seers did not see coming, but instead they come off as incredibly incompetent as she tries this really stupid plan that, of course, doesn't work. And honestly, it makes me think less of the entire Raza crew. And then there was the thing with Four suggesting that Nix's brother commit suicide, which I got from the first scene where he left the knife with the apple that he gave him, and that's all that they needed to show. Instead, they kept beating us over the head with it as he suggested to Nix that there was no other option, and then eventually just pretty much said it outright to her brother. And these were not necessary. The apple scene was all you needed. Plus, it seemed like such an obvious outcome. I don't buy that the series wouldn't see this coming. Plus, yeah, it's kind of a boring way for this story to end. However, I knew Nix's brother wouldn't be around for future episodes, so it was just a matter of how they would get rid of him. So, we also get a storyline with Three being trapped with Six, and he's still furious at Six for betraying them, and for the most part, I found the storyline dull and uninteresting. However, I do appreciate that they're allowing time for Six to slowly become part of the crew again, and they addressed Three, who was his biggest hurdle, as it would have been stupid if Six just instantly went back to being normal after what he did, so at least they are addressing this in a good way. So my rating for We Should Have Seen This Coming out of 10 is a 6 good. We got an exciting episode with the introduction of a great new villain, as well as we learn Nix's backstory, which makes her 10 times more interesting. That, and she's starting to become a normal member of the crew, and is making her one of the most interesting characters on the whole show. But the resolution to this episode was incredibly weak, and ironically predictable. So that's it for my review of We Should Have Seen This Coming. Be sure to check back here every week as I continue to review episodes of Dark Matter. And be sure to check out my channel as I do many more videos on shows like Game of Thrones, Star Trek, Mr. Robot, and more. So be sure to subscribe so you can keep up with all of that. Thanks a lot for watching.